Okay, some letters. Here we go. S. Nope. T. Yes, one T. Yes. A. Nope, you get a body. E. E. R. Oh, man. Yes. O. Y. 26 letters. Look at that one. N. Sorry, no N, just the lid. P. Wow, you guys are good. Yes. B. Yes, there's a B. Puberty. Ding, ding, ding. Yes.
Is that really your word, Austin?
Seriously, man, why'd you pick puberty?
Because that's what we're learning about in health class next week. And I know you're all really excited.
That's not funny, man.
No, that's not funny at all.
I just hope it's not going to be too embarrassing. Personally, I don't think it's going to be such a big deal.
Yeah, me neither. My brother said he actually learned something. And trust me, he knows everything.
Yes, puberty can seem weird and a little uncomfortable, and you probably have questions you're afraid to ask. In fact, you may have lots of questions since much of this is all new to you. Or maybe you just started thinking about it, like right now. So here's your chance to ask anything. Don't be shy. I'm here to help.
So, what exactly is puberty anyway?
Thanks for asking, Jenny. Puberty is a series of changes that your body and all of your friends' bodies will go through as you grow up. It may seem a bit confusing or even a little embarrassing, but don't worry. It happens to everyone, boys and girls, and it's totally normal. For girls, you'll get taller during puberty, your breasts will get bigger, you'll start growing body hair in new places, and you may get body odor. Your skin and hair may become oily, and you may get pimples. You may also get angry more easily and go through mood swings. The biggest change you'll experience, however, is that you'll start your period. Now, along with those changes comes more freedom and responsibilities. So you're going to need to work hard to make grown-up decisions, which is also an important part of getting older.
Wow, that's pretty intense. But what causes all these changes?
Actually, something really cool causes all these changes. You see, it all starts here in a tiny little gland located under the front of your brain called the pituitary gland. As you begin puberty, usually between the ages of 8 and 13 for girls, your pituitary gland sends a signal to your ovaries to begin making a hormone called estrogen. The estrogen made by your ovaries during puberty travels throughout your entire body and causes all the changes we just discussed. Boys go through this process too, but the hormone in charge of their body changes is called testosterone. During puberty, you'll start growing pubic hair in your pubic area, under your arms, and you'll grow more hair on your legs. Your body shape will become softer and curvier, your hips will get wider, and your breasts will get fuller. These changes mean you're becoming a woman, and it all leads up to you being physically able to have a baby someday. But remember, a baby is a big responsibility, and you're probably not ready for that yet.
My friend says everyone starts to stink when they go through puberty. Is that true?
Actually, Maria, that's not exactly true. First of all, everyone sweats. Boys, girls, even babies. That's because we're all born with sweat glands called eccrine glands, which produce clear, odorless perspiration that cools your body when it gets too hot. But once you hit puberty, different sweat glands, called apocrine glands, also start working. Now, when the sweat they produce mixes with bacteria on your skin, it can cause body odor, also known as BO. So what's the best way to deal with BO? Take a shower or a bath every day, and be sure to use soap or body wash. Another way to help minimize BO and feel less stinky is to use a deodorant, or a deodorant with antiperspirant to help keep body odor in check.
But what about my face? Am I gonna get pimples?
Oh, that depends. You see, besides sweat, there's something else your body will start producing during puberty. It's called sebum. It's an oily substance that can cause acne, also called pimples. Acne is really common during puberty and can't always be prevented, even by washing all the time. The best way to help keep your skin clear is to wash your face twice a day with a gentle cleanser. And remember to use a moisturizer. And one more thing, sebum can make your hair look and feel greasy too. So be sure to shampoo regularly to keep your hair clean and healthy. And to keep it from being frizzy, try using a light conditioner and a wide tooth comb when your hair is wet. Washing it every day or every other day is best for most hair types.
But do I really have to brush my teeth twice a day?
Yes, actually you do. Brushing helps keep your teeth healthy and clean. And more importantly, it can keep you from having dragon breath. So remember, the best way to avoid dragon breath is to brush your teeth properly every morning and every night with a good toothpaste.
My sister has a pretty big chest. Are my boobs gonna get as big as hers?
Well, Mandy, a lot of that depends on your family. If the women in your family have large breasts, then chances are yours may be big too. The same thing is true if the women in your family have smaller breasts. But remember, breasts come in all shapes and sizes. That's why they make bras in all shapes and sizes too, so you get the right support. They even come in different colors. Finally, every girl's chest develops differently. So even if some of the girls you know already seem big to you, no worries. Your breasts will fill out when the time is right.
How will I know when I'm gonna get my first period?
Here's the deal, Suzette. The only way to know for sure when you're going to get your first period is by pulling the date you're going to start out of a magic hat. Just kidding. The real answer is that no one knows. Your body is unique and definitely on its own schedule. Generally speaking, however, you can expect to start your period about 2 years after your breasts start to develop and you start growing pubic hair. Another important sign that your period is on its way is called vaginal discharge, which may sound worse than it is. Actually, it's just a clear or whitish fluid that comes from your vagina, and it's completely normal. So when you notice a creamy white stain in your underwear for the first time, it usually means your first period is coming soon.
Once I start, will it come on the same day every month?
In the beginning, your period might not be regular. Actually, it can take a year or two for a girl's body to settle into a regular cycle. After you've had your period for a while, though, it will most likely happen like clockwork. A normal period comes about once a month, or about every 28 days. If you want to figure out when to expect your period, it's easy. Just mark the first day you start on a calendar, then count 28 days and put another mark on the calendar. That way you'll have a good idea when it's coming. Or you can be more high-tech and track your period online by using the helpful period calculator on beinggirl.com.
Why do women have periods anyway?
Good question, Katie. Women have periods because of our reproductive system, which allows us to get pregnant once we're adults. Here's how your reproductive system works. Each month, your body produces hormones that cause an egg in one of your ovaries to mature and ripen. At the same time, the lining of your uterus, called the endometrium, begins to thicken. When your egg is fully mature, your ovary releases it into your fallopian tube. The egg then begins its journey through the fallopian tube toward your uterus. If the egg is fertilized by the male reproductive cell, called the sperm, while it's in the fallopian tube, the egg will attach to the endometrial lining on the inside wall of the uterus. Most of the time, however, the egg is not fertilized by a sperm, so the endometrium isn't needed. The endometrium and unfertilized egg leave your body through the vagina. When you shed this blood and tissue, it's called menstruation, or having a period.
Wow, so how much blood is there?
Not very much, actually. You'll only lose about 4 to 12 teaspoons of blood and tissue, and it doesn't come out all at once. On average, it takes most women about 5 days for it all to come out.
This whole thing seems sort of gross. Do all girls get a period? Even my teachers?
Yes. Almost every girl gets a period, usually between the ages of 10 and 16. And yes, your female teachers get their period too. Just remember, starting your period is nothing to be ashamed of. And using period protection like pads and panty liners can help you feel fresh and clean, not gross. Plus, don't forget that your mom and your aunts have periods too. So if you have questions, don't be shy about asking. They can be a big help.
And if it's helpful for you, write down your questions and find a casual time to start the discussion. It can be in the car, after school, or you can even leave her a note telling her you'd like to talk to her soon.
My two best friends already have their period, but I don't. Is something wrong with me?
No, Mandy, there's nothing wrong with you. Now, I know you want to do everything that your best friends do, but be patient. Keep in mind that some girls get their period in elementary school, and some girls don't get their period until they're in high school. So be cool, your body is on its own schedule, and it's totally okay if your friends are at different stages than you.
Does it hurt to have a period?
Sometimes girls experience what are called period cramps. These happen because your uterus contracts or squeezes together when it's shedding its lining. Some girls get cramps, some girls don't. It actually depends on your body. If you do get cramps, though, mild exercise usually helps and can actually prevent them altogether. You can also try taking a hot bath or using a heating pad to help you feel more comfortable.
But what about PMS? It seems like my older sister's so dramatic when she's about to start.
Ah, the dreaded PMS. You see, in addition to cramps, some girls experience what's called premenstrual syndrome, also known as PMS. PMS is caused by changing hormone levels, and it's a medical term used to describe symptoms that some girls feel about a week or so before they start their periods. Now, I'm sure you've heard a lot of jokes about PMS.
Like, do boys get PMS?
Nice one. No, of course boys don't get PMS. But it is, in fact, a very real thing for some girls, and they include mood swings, breast tenderness, or a bloated feeling. You can help minimize these symptoms by making sure you get enough exercise, sleep, and proper nutrition.
So, can people tell when I'm on my period?
Okay, so here's the two-syllable answer, N-O. And that's important because no one will be able to tell if you're on your period unless you tell them. So, here's a hint. Don't tell them, and they won't know. Also, keep in mind that your period shouldn't stop you from exercising, participating in gym class, or doing any of your regular activities.
What do I do if my period starts when I'm at school?
Great question, Olivia. A lot of girls your age worry about starting their period at school. And while you can't control it, you can be prepared. Here's a tip. Put together a backpack kit. It's easy. All you have to do is get a little makeup bag and put three things in it. A pad, a panty liner, and a change of underwear. Once everything is in there, just put the makeup bag in your backpack and you're good to go. Another thing you can do is wear a panty liner every day, especially if you think you're going to start soon. Oh, and in case of an at-school emergency, you can always use folded up toilet paper in your panties until you can get a pad.
How do those pad things work?
Pads are worn in your underwear during your period to absorb your menstrual flow. The pad is a soft, cotton-like layer on the top and a sticky strip on the bottom to keep it firmly in place in your underwear.
So, how exactly do I use a pad?
It's super easy. You just unwrap the pad, pull off the paper strip that covers the sticky part on the bottom, then you stick the pad on the center part of your underwear. If your pad has wings, then wrap them around the sides. When you need to change it, just pull the pad off to remove it. Fold it up and put it in the wrapper from the new pad you're going to use, or you can wrap it in toilet paper. Then just throw it away in the trash can. Most girls' restrooms also have little trash cans next to the toilet where you can put your used pads and panty liners.
Oh, so that's what those are for.
Yes, they're really convenient and discreet. But remember, never flush pads or panty liners because they'll clog the toilet.
Wow, you're right. That is super easy. But how often do I change a pad?
You should change your pad every 4 to 6 hours, or more often if your flow is heavy. They make pads in different absorbencies, so you can find the one that's best for you. Oh, and here's a tip. Always change your pad before bedtime. You can also use special overnight pads that are larger in the back to help avoid leaks when you're lying down.
I live with my dad. Do I have to tell him about my period?
Listen, it's really up to you. I know what's happening to your body can seem embarrassing, but it's a normal thing that every girl goes through. And of course, your dad doesn't know what it's like to have a period, but he does understand why and how it happens. So if you feel comfortable telling your dad that you started your period, then great. He may actually surprise you with how cool he is about it. If you prefer not to talk to him, though, that's fine too. If it makes you feel more comfortable, then talk to your mom, a step-parent, a friend's mom, or another adult you trust. Especially if you have questions before you start or need someone to buy you pads so you're prepared when you do start.
What can I do to stay healthy while my body goes through all these changes?
The three things you need to do during puberty are eat properly, exercise, and get plenty of rest. Select a healthy range of foods that will help you get all the vitamins and nutrients your body needs, and minimize junk food. Eat lots of fresh fruits and vegetables, proteins like meat, milk, eggs, and beans, and complex carbohydrates like whole wheat breads, pastas, and cereals. Another way to be healthy as you're growing into your new body is to exercise every day. Try going for a walk, riding your bike, or dancing to your favorite song. It will keep your body strong and healthy, and it's a lot of fun too. And most importantly, get plenty of sleep. About 8 to 9 hours every night. That way, your body has lots of energy for the next day.
What if I have more questions that come up? Who should I ask?
The best place to start is to talk to your mom, dad, or another adult you trust. It can be your aunt, a friend's mom, your grandmother, or an older sibling who's been there and done that. I know that asking questions about puberty may seem a little embarrassing at first, but don't be afraid. They've all been through puberty themselves. So when you have questions, don't wait. Start the conversation. Trust me, you'll feel better after you do. And you'll feel good knowing that the people you love and trust can be there to help.
Four, Mark.
Nice work.